Hey there, scientist! Welcome back to the Science Studio. I finished my sound sculpture and sent it off to our local art museum. Now, I'm working on a new project. Today, I noticed an interesting shadow on the studio wall and decided to paint it. But wait, where did it go? It was just there a minute ago. How can a shadow just disappear? Let's solve this mystery together. What can make a shadow just vanish like that? Let's think about what makes a shadow in the first place. I think it has something to do with light. Okay, let's experiment. I'm going to shine this light on the marker. Watch closely. Look, there's the shadow. The light hits the marker and a shadow forms behind it. But what's actually happening here? When the light shines on the marker, it can't go through. The marker blocks the light and leaves a dark shape behind it. That's the shadow. And see what happens when I move the light? The shadow moves too. It's all because the marker is blocking the light. Shadows are just areas where the light can't reach because something is in the way. Like our marker here. So that means something must have been blocking the light from the sun to make the shadow I saw on the wall. But that still doesn't tell me why it disappeared. What if something happened to the light? Could the light have changed somehow to make the shadow go away? Wait, the light in the studio comes from the sun. What if the sun moved or something got in the way? Maybe that's why the shadow disappeared. If the light source changes, the shadow might change too. I think we're onto something. We need to figure out what changed with the light when the shadow disappeared. So, we know shadows happen when something blocks the light, like our marker here. But if my shadow disappeared, maybe it's because something didn't block the light completely. What if I shine the light through this? Look, there's no shadow. That's because the glass lets most of the light go through. Maybe that's why the shadow I saw vanished. It wasn't blocked enough to make a dark shadow like before. Do you think this will block the light? Yeah. It only blocks some of the light. See how the shadow is a little fuzzy and not as dark? It's because light can pass through this material, but not all of it. But when I hold this book in front of the light, no light gets through at all, and the shadow is really dark. This object is solid. So, if my shadow disappeared earlier, it might be because whatever was blocking the light wasn't solid enough to create a strong shadow. Okay, we've learned so much about shadows. We know that they're made when something blocks the light. We also discovered that some objects let light through, making lighter shadows or no shadows at all. So, what about that disappearing shadow I saw earlier? Wait a second. The light in the studio changed. When I first saw the shadow, the sun was shining right through the window. But now, the sun has moved and the light isn't hitting the same spot anymore. Do you remember what happened when we moved the flashlight around earlier? Yeah, the shadow of our marker changed. The shadow disappeared because the light moved. When the light source changes, the shadow moves or disappears with it. It wasn't just the object blocking the light. It was the light itself moving that made the shadow disappear. We solved the mystery. Shadows change because the light changes. If the light source moves, the shadows move too. That's why the shadow on the wall was there one moment and gone the next. It was all about how the sunlight moved through the studio. I guess I'll have to wait for that shadow to show up again so I can paint it. Thanks for helping me today, scientist. Until next time, keep creating, and I'll see you in the science studio. Hey, hey.